Abhi hum Tangelos ke kitchen mein hain and we're about to have a yummy taste of Italy. We're hum Mohammed Saleem saab ke saath hain aur wo hamare liye chicken lasagna banane lage hain. Aur chicken lasagna thoda sa spicy rakhiyega, theek hai? Aur kyunki main to bahut zyada spicy khati hu, I love spicy food. But main unse ye puchna cha rahi hu ki chicken lasagna mein exactly dalta kya hai aur kitna time lagta hai, and matlab how do you make it so good?
थैंक यू नाइला, आपने हमारे किचन में विज़िट किया और आपने हमारा फूड चेक किया, थैंक यू सो मच. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल कि लाजानिया जो है हमारा जो बहुत अच्छा यहाँ पे लोग कस्टमर जो है बहुत ज़्यादा पसंद करते हैं. मैक्सिमम 20 से 25 मिनट में हम लोग डिलीवर कर देते हैं और फ्रेश और ज़बरदस्त आपको प्रेजेंटेशन के साथ हम लोग डिलीवर करते हैं बहुत कम टाइम में, और बहुत ही अच्छा टेस्ट और बहुत अच्छा आपको फ्लेवर आपको यहाँ मिलेगा, बहुत अच्छा माहौल भी मिलेगा, तो कस्टमर बहुत खुश है, अल्लाह का शुक्र है.
मेरा दूसरा सवाल ये है कि आपके जो इंग्रेडिएंट्स हैं इस किचन में वो फ्रेश होते हैं या आप लोग यू नो फ्रोजन इंग्रेडिएंट्स इस्तेमाल करते हैं? बिकॉज मुझे लगता है कि आप लोग फ्रेश इंग्रेडिएंट्स ही इस्तेमाल करते हैं.
हर चीज़ हमारे यहाँ से चिकन बीफ जो भी चीज़ आपको वेजिटेबल वगैरह हर चीज़ फ्रेश हम लोग इस्तेमाल करते हैं. पहले हम लोग ना उसको आप ये नहीं कह सकते कि हमने पहले से हमने उसको कोई तैयारी किया हुआ हो या हमने उसमें पहले हाफ डन किया, वो हर चीज़ हमारी यहाँ पर फ्रेश तैयार होती है और बहुत अच्छा टेस्ट है, बहुत अच्छा कमेंट्स लोगों के आ रहे हैं और कस्टमर जो भी आते हैं माशाल्लाह बहुत अच्छा तारीफ करके जाते हैं.
Assalamu alaikum, ladies and gentlemen. You're watching Sundown Evening Tea with me, Naila Shuja. And today we're sitting with Ms. Tahira Malik, who is a versatile kind of individual. She's clearly loved to study. I mean, yes. You've done 3 master's degrees.
Yes.
And including ek hai LLM in human rights. And you also have a psychotherapy degree. A level 5 diploma in counseling from CPCAB, United Kingdom.
Yes.
And oh my God, I have so many questions right now, just all in my mind, just jumbled up. But thank you for joining me here at Tangelos.
Thank you for having me.
And to shuru karte hain guftugu ka aghaz. I just wanted, let's start off with what exactly is psychotherapy. I mean, you hear it around in shows. Usually serials mein hota hai, people are discussing psychologists, yeah. Psychiatrists, therapists, and then psychotherapy. Can you tell us a little bit about it?
People also say psychiatry.
Bilkul.
In the same field. So yeah. Psychotherapy is, if I put it in simple terms, it's when you have a problem or you feel stuck at a state of your life, or when you experience extreme maybe anxiety or there's a problem in your life, so you go to an expert who has been trained to help you cope with the problem. So you can talk to them, it can go on for months, it can go on for years also. Sometimes it's solution focused, so they give you a time, 6 to 8 weeks.
Yeah.
So you sit with the therapist for an hour, once in a week or maybe twice a month.
Yeah.
And you discuss, the therapist is trained to look at the reason behind your problem.
The very fundamental reasons, yes. The basic causes of why you
feel, and they're trained to know that through the talk. They're also trained to make you solve your problems yourself. So one thing that people say ki ji aap hame solution batayenge, to hum ye unhe kehte ki nahi, hum aapko solution dhoondne mein madad karenge aapke apne masail.
So the solution lies within the person.
The person, yes, okay. Of course. So everything, hamara ye manna hai ki everything except for some extreme things have a solution.
So, what kind of problems do you face? What are the most heightened problems that you've dealt with personally regarding your clients?
Cancer? Yeah. In my experience, people in Pakistan usually come with symptoms of depression and anxiety mostly, where people are restless, people get angry a lot sometimes, or people lose interest in life at all. Throughout their work, their education, they have no interest.
उनकी सोशल लाइफ बहुत कम हो जाती है,
ये होता है. इसके अलावा मैरिटल प्रॉब्लम्स के लोग अब बहुत आ रहे हैं, व्हिच इज ग्रेट आल्सो, सैड आल्सो, बट इट्स ग्रेट दैट पीपल आर ब्रिंगिंग देयर मैरिटल प्रॉब्लम्स. सो कपल्स कम टू अस फॉर कपल काउंसलिंग. इसके अलावा एक्सट्रीम केसेस भी आते हैं जहाँ पे थोड़ा साइकोसिस, जो मेंटल इलनेसेज हैं, जिसका मैं हमारा हो चुके नहीं होता है तायरा कार में, तो हम उनको वी रेफर देम टू साइकियाट्रिस्ट.
Okay.
A psychiatrist is basically a doctor, MBBS doctor, with a specialization in psychiatry, who can prescribe them medicines.
All right. So what exactly is the difference between a psychotherapist and a psychologist?
They are cousins, you can say. They are similar. But psychologists particularly are more trained in assessing your personality type, in giving you tests of different kinds, personality tests, and they can also do therapy. Right?
All right.
The psychotherapist is basically trained in talk therapy, which you say, where you talk about your issues, and they can tell that your issues are stemming maybe from your childhood experiences. So they are trained in theories related to childhood. They're not that trained in assessment, but we do get training. But in organizations, usually we work alongside psychologists. So both have different areas. So in an organization where we work, usually we have a psychologist who do the personality testing, basic assessments, form filling and all, and then we have the sessions.
All right. So you've studied law as yeah. you know, in your bachelor's and your yeah. master's, yeah. and then you went on to study literature and linguistics yeah. as your master's yeah. You know, degree. So where did, you know, counseling come from? Where did psychotherapy come from?
Yeah.
There are such diverse fields and disciplines.
It came very late, actually. And I did my master's and my law together. I used to study in the master's in the morning and then the law classes in the evening.
Oh my goodness.
Yes, I was an only child, so my parents wanted me to study for 4 kids they couldn't have. Or 3 kids. So yeah, so subah mein master's hota tha, shaam mein law hota tha.
Achha.
Haan, is tarah maine padhai kar li us zamane mein. And then I did another master's when I first finished my master's in literature, then I did my master's in teaching of English. And therapy came 6 years ago. I was at a stage of my life where I was teaching in the university, and I thought I'm done with my studies. And I was sitting in a shop, I remember, and there was this newspaper with the advertisement that it's a UK course being offered in Pakistan. And then I thought this was my calling, and I joined it, and then there was no turning back because this was basically my calling and
Achha.
I didn't know it. This was basically my aptitude towards that, helping people, connecting with people. But somehow I mere time mein aur shayad abhi bhi itni youth ko help nahi hai.
So aap ye law ke through nahi kar sakti thi, you know, when it comes to helping people. What was the sole reason that you decided to choose psychology? Not psychology, psychotherapy,
yes,
sorry.
Yes, yes.
But what was the major calling? I mean, what was that moment in your life just where you just realized, you know, this is it. This is who I am supposed to be.
Now that we are talking about it, now I realize that I was in US for some time and I did go to a therapist okay. for some issues I was dealing with. So I think at that time, it was I think 10 years ago, I think that was my first introduction, and that was somewhere in my mind, the way the therapist helped me and the way she showed me areas in my own personality that I didn't know about. I think that was the time, Naila, now that I'm thinking, when I realized that this is something I would want to do. And then when I saw, but there was nothing in Pakistan at that time. You had a very set course, you have to bachelor's in psychology, then you have to clinical psychology, master's, so I didn't have that interest. So these courses, when I came and I saw that UK courses in Pakistan, so I think I clicked on my experience in America.
Hey, this is where you should be, this is. And so basically what you've said is that it was something that you faced a problem and you decided to consult
a therapist
or a professional who was qualified enough to actually guide you through this.
To help me, yeah.
Guide you through your difficult time
yes,
in life.
Yes.
So that's wonderful. And you're also a lecturer.
Yes.
And so you've kind of mixed a variety of fields together and
yes.
Created a very unique concoction. Jisme, you're targeting the youth basically.
Yes.
And how are you doing that exactly?
Mostly my clients are also under 20, 25, 30, and for the people I teach, they are an undergrad. So I think it gives me a great opportunity to connect to people, where I connect with the youth, I look at their problems. As a teacher also, I get a very limited chance to help them. But as a therapist, I think it gives me a lot of room.
A more one-on-one interaction
yes.
with the
yes.
students.
Because they are more open to me
because.
In that room. So yeah, it has helped me a lot.
So what were some of the major problems that your students faced or face, you know, till this day, because you're still a teacher? So what are the some of the major problems that you see in your students?
I think the major problem, one that is running through all the age groups before 25, it's in fact after 25 also, is lack of understanding from the older generation. Yeah, with the generation
How
gap
so?
Hai, wo bada cliche ek term to ban gaya, but it's very much present. Where my students, I think half of them sometimes they tell me in the beginning of the class, ma'am, hume ye nahi karna tha. Hame abbu ne bhej diya, hame ammi ne bhej diya. So I think the selection of the field where the students have faced this problem, they didn't want to do it. Many of my students, male students mostly wanted to be cricketers, professional cricketers.
Oh.
But parents ne kaha ki beta pehle na ye degree kara. Hmm. फिर तुम क्रिकेटर बन
जाओ। कोई बैकअप प्लान हो ताकि यू नो
ये प्रॉब्लम मेरे स्टूडेंट्स को बहुत है जो मुझे लगता है कि जो एक लैक ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग है ना फ्रॉम ओल्डर जनरेशन
सो व्हाट यू आर ट्राइंग टू से इज दैट देयर नीड्स टू बी मोर करियर काउंसलिंग विद इन इंस्टीट्यूशंस
यस
सो हाउ आर यू एक्टिंग एज अ करियर काउंसलर फॉर योर स्टूडेंट्स
Naila, I don't, again, I said, as a teacher, I don't get a lot of room for this because I have to go there, I deliver a lecture, I try to help them when they come and talk to me.
Okay.
But since I do not work with that counseling thing, I do try my best, but do a career counseling jo proper hai na, jo universities mein kaha to jata hai ki hai, but unfortunately, maine nahi dekha bahut students ko wahan pe jate hue. Because career counseling is not just career counseling, it's you have to look at the person. You know who the person
you
is.
You have to evaluate
know
them.
Know the person, yes. So, yeah. मेरा ख्याल है मैं इतना कर नहीं पाती, but जितना होता है, मैं उनकी help कर देती हूँ. And mostly जब मुझे students मिलते हैं, तो वो degree में पहुँच चुके होते हैं half way. तो अगर मैं उन्हें कह दूँ कि नहीं ये ठीक नहीं है, you can change. I do tell them my story. I changed my profession after being done and after working, and I completely changed it. I'm so happy now. So I give them my example. I try, but ज़्यादा counselling करना मेरे लिए मुश्किल हो जाता है. लेकिन ज़रूरत बहुत है. मैं सुनने वालों को भी यही कहूँगी. कि एक घर में काउंसलिंग की अगर सोसाइटी नहीं भी दे रही है तो घर में एक ओपननेस होनी चाहिए फादर से बात करने की मदर से बात करने की बड़ों से वो होनी चाहिए
मगर यूजुअली हमारी सोसाइटी में ये मसला है कि थोड़ी सी झिझक होती है कि वी कैन रियली टॉक टू आवर पेरेंट्स एज ओपनली एज वी टॉक टू आवर फ्रेंड्स और टीचर इन दैट वे हाउ कैन वी रिमूव दोज बैरियर्स हम कैसे अपने पेरेंट्स के पास जा सकते हैं और उनसे इस तरह की बातें कर सकते हैं कि मैंने शायद डॉक्टर नहीं बनना मैंने शायद लॉयर नहीं बनना शायद इंजीनियरिंग नहीं करना तो हाउ कैन वी टॉक टू आवर पेरेंट्स अबाउट दीज थिंग्स
हाँ सी अगर पेरेंट्स हमें सुन रहे हैं तो मैं समझती हूँ कि पेरेंट्स की जिम्मेदारी ज़्यादा है पहले उनकी है मैं सेकेंड उस पर भी बताऊँगी आपको बट पहले तो पेरेंट्स की है ना वेयर वी थिंक कि दुनिया में 7 बिलियन 7.5 बिलियन लोग हैं और वो सब थंब प्रिंट उनका डिफरेंट है फिंगर प्रिंट डिफरेंट है तो इसका मतलब है मेरा माई चाइल्ड इज़ ऑल्सो अ वेरी यूनिक इंडिविजुअल सो ही और शी कैन हैव अ डिफरेंट perspective or I shouldn't live my dreams through my child.
Yeah, that's so. A very prominent problem that we have within Pakistan that oh we couldn't become a doctor so I think my child has to become a doctor to fulfill my dream and you know create a legacy for myself
and my child has to be the top on everything because I want to show my cousin fulan 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 and my uncles that I am the best mother maybe सो एक तो वो ख़त्म होगा तो खुद ही बैरियर थोड़ा कम हो जाएगा नंबर टू पेरेंट्स से बात करने का भी कुछ तरीके हैं हम जब जाते हैं तो हम बहुत कन्फ्रंटेशनल मोड में होते हैं बिकॉज वी आर एक्सपेक्टिंग देम टू एक्ट सर्टन वे सो इफ वी टेक देम एज अ ह्यूमन बीइंग द वेरी समटाइम्स वेरी फॉल्टी फॉल्टी इंडिविजुअल तो अगर हम पेरेंट्स को थोड़ा वो नीचे ले आएँ अपने नज़रों में थोड़ा सा बराबरी के उस पर देखें कि इनकी भी ज़िंदगी है इनकी भी गलतियाँ हुई हैं उनसे उम्मीदें छोड़ दें परफेक्शन की
वो अलग बात है हमें नहीं पता
बट उन्होंने भी गलतियाँ की हैं देयर एज केयर देयर एज अनश्योर ऑफ देयर डिसीजन सो मे बी इफ यू टॉक टू देम विद अ जेंटल असर्टिवनेस जैसे हम कहते हैं नॉट विद एग्रेशन मेरे जितने स्टूडेंट्स मुझसे बात करते हैं नाइला वो यही कहते हैं कि यार लड़ाई हो गई घर में अबू से तो मैं उनसे पूछती हूँ take me back to the conversation
yeah walk but me through it and then we'll figure
yes,
it out
I realized that the student himself or herself was very angry when they entered the conversation
so matlab aap ye kehna cha rahi hain ki when we speak to our parents we need to have a more calm demeanor we need to kind of collect our thoughts and emotions.
Look at them as a part, human being who has made mistakes
and then we talk to them about the issue but kuch parents aise bhi hote hain jo baat sunna hi nahi chahte how can we target those parents
us pe to pura program hona chahiye I think jo parents baat sunna nahi chahte I think the hum ek batate hain apne clients ko aisa tarika ki you become the broken record jo phans jata hai na record bar bar ek hi baat karta hai so you fix your tone you set a very neutral tone and you keep saying the same thing so whatever wo jo bhi baat kare wo pehle aapko taane denge ki tum nalayak aulad ho to aap kahe nahi ammi maine ye karna hai मैंने बीबीए नहीं करना फॉर एग्जांपल या मैंने फिलहाल डिग्री में डॉक्टर नहीं बनना तुम बहुत ही फजूल औलाद हो, तुम पैदा ही क्यों नहीं अम्मी, बट स्टिल मैं डॉक्टर नहीं बना, आई मेरी तो किस्मत खत्म, मैं तो मरने वाली हूँ या मरने वाला हूँ,
वो थोड़ा सा इमोशनल,
हाँ, दे विल ट्राई एवरीथिंग टू मेक यू नो लूज योर टेंपर, बिकॉज़ इस तरह ही हमारे यहाँ तो ट्रेनिंग हुई है ना, हमारी बहुत चीज़ों में मेरी जो एक फ्रीडम था एज अ वुमन, इट वॉज डिफिकल्ट फॉर माई मदर टू रियलाइज दैट नाउ शी इज ग्रोन अप, सो शी कैन मेक हर ओन डिसीजन, शी कैन गो आउट sometimes to have some lunch with friends.
Oh, so I'm so happy chai aa gayi. I'm really really happy,
thank you. Unke liye mushkil tha thoda, but I became very very assertive. Shukriya. But then she tried everything, then she tried of course aggression, then she tried getting my sympathy. She would get sick, she would get,
please have some tea, would you like some sugar?
No thank you.
Okay,
so wo har cheez try kar chuki thi, but I stood my ground.
पर कभी कभार ऐसे भी फील हो जाता है कि यू नो मे बी वेयर रॉन्ग, मे बी वी शुड डू व्हाट आवर पेरेंट्स वांट अस टू डू, बिकॉज दे यू नो लिव फॉर सो लॉन्ग, दे हैव दैट एक्सपीरियंस, एंड यूजुअली वो ये कहते हैं ना कि तुम मेरी माँ ना बनो, वो ये वाला कॉन्सेप्ट आ जाता है. हाँ जी बिल्कुल.
नाइला उसमें मेरी थेरेपी ने मेरी बड़ी हेल्प की है, मैं खुद भी पर्सनल थेरेपी में हूँ.
अच्छा.
आई हैव माई ओन थेरेपिस्ट.
ओके.
आई थिंक नोइंग दैट आई नो एंड नोइंग दैट आई विल मेक द राइट डिसीजन बिकॉज आई एम अ एबल ह्यूमन बीइंग, आई एम अ वर्दी ह्यूमन बीइंग, ये जो आपके अंदर इनकलकेट किया है, दिस वाज इनकलकेटेड इन मी बाय माई थेरेपिस्ट.
सो यू आर सेल्फ कॉन्शियस एज वेल, नॉट सेल्फ कॉन्शियस बट यू आर अवेयर, यू आर अवेयर ऑफ द फैक्ट दैट देयर आर सम मे बी not grand or at that large scale of problems within you, but you are aware that maybe, because human beings are, you know, imperfect, we do have problems, and
you
it could be the smallest
sometimes.
Yeah, we create problems.
Yes.
Oh my goodness, we create a lot of problems.
So to be a therapist, Naila, you have to be in therapy yourself.
Okay.
So it's mandatory on me, mere pe hota hai, hum practice hi nahi kar sakte agar hum apni therapy ka proof na dein. So because if I'm not in therapy, I can not, you know, help anybody else. So okay. I think that has helped me, but unfortunately jo hamari youth hai,
okay,
ya sare log hain, sabke paas itne avenues nahi hain ki wo khud bhi therapy mein aaye.
And I feel that the concept of therapy is very, it has a negative connotation in Pakistan. Yes. People don't really think of it as a helping activity, they think of it as, oh, you're going to a random stranger and going to tell them everything about yourself.
Yes.
And what if they breach confidentiality? What's going to happen then?
और हमें क्या मसला है कि तुम जाके हमारे मसले लोगों को बताओ?
बिल्कुल. And I've seen it around my surroundings as well. Why do you need to go talk to a stranger?
Yeah.
Why can't you talk to your parents or your brother or your sister or your cousin?
या तुम्हें मसला ही क्या है? सबसे बड़ा तो मैंने सुना है अपने clients को, अपने students को, जब parents कहते हैं कि disregard करते हैं, disregard their problem, then they say, what is your problem? Yeah, what is your problem? So I think, yeah, but the good thing is, Naila, there are a lot of people coming to therapy now. In Islamabad alone, there are so many therapists practicing, private practice mein, and people are coming.
Okay, so can you tell me the point at which someone should be self-aware or conscious enough to comprehend that they need or they should go to a therapist or a psychologist? What is that point where you think someone should consult someone?
There are many points actually, Naila, but I think the major signal that the life gives you is when you feel stuck. I think one of the signals where you feel stuck and you cannot make a decision, and when you feel lonely or you feel that, okay, I think I don't know what to do. Right?
अब क्या करना चाहिए? What's the next step? So usually, मतलब I recently graduated, so I've just completed my bachelor's degree, and within my surroundings, I feel that a lot of people my age who just completed a degree, they feel very stuck.
Yes.
Because they're not aware or they're not sure how to get the perfect job. Because we're all in search of perfect.
Yes.
Perfect hume milega nahi. So we try to make do with what we can. How do we understand that this is either a phase or this is something that we really need to work on?
I think both are the same, Naila. If your colleagues, if your peers are not sure.
सबसे पहले तो I'm so sorry.
Thank you.
Interrupting you. Please, आप ले थोड़ा सा ले.
Thank you.
This is Tangelos Chicken Lasagna.
Okay, looks
and
great.
And it looks so cheesy.
Yes.
I feel like I should get it packed.
है ना हाँ.
Because I love cheese.
And it's really, yeah, really nice.
ओके डेफिनेटली तो आप बोल रही थी
हाँ तो आई थिंक ये दोनों चीज़ें आपने एक ही बात बोली कि फेस में है या हमें कुछ देखना चाहिए आई थिंक दोनों एक जगह भी हो सकते हैं आपको देखना भी चाहिए तब भी एक फेस है एवरीथिंग इज़ अ फेस अगर आई टेल माय क्लाइंट्स एंड आई टेल समटाइम्स द पेरेंट्स हु कम टू मी कि मेरा बच्चा तो बस बच्ची तो ख़राब हो गई बच्चा तो हाथ से गया तो समटाइम्स आई टेल देम कि मे बी इट्स जस्ट अ फेस एक्सपेरिमेंटिंग थ्रू और आपके गलत रिएक्शन से ये पक्का ही ना हो जाए
बिल्कुल मतलब देर शुड ऑलवेज ए पॉजिटिव रीइन्फोर्समेंट विद इन द फैमिलियल स्ट्रक्चर
एनी एज इट्स नॉट अबाउट के बच्चे छोटे हैं तो उनको दिया जाए बड़े होके नहीं तो आई थिंक ये जो आपने बात की कि हाँ मुझे नहीं पता मुझे क्या करना है ये भी ये शो करता है कि उसको ये नहीं पता कि वो है कौन
बिल्कुल वी हैव अ प्रॉब्लम वी गो इन टू प्रोग्राम्स वी स्टडी सब्जेक्ट्स दैट वी आर नॉट श्योर वी वॉन्ट टू कम्प्लीट और वी वॉन्ट टू परस्यू फर्दर
एंड दिस इज वेरी कॉमन दिस इज समथिंग दैट आई हैव कम अक्रॉस अ लॉट कि बच्चे आते हैं वो कहते हैं हमें नहीं पता था कि ये डिग्री हमें करनी चाहिए थी तो आई थिंक उस टाइम भी यू राइट हम यू कैन गो टू थेरेपिस्ट वेयर यू रियलाइज व्हाट यू एक्चुअली वांट एंड हाउ टू लर्न द स्किल्स टू कम्युनिकेट विद योर पेरेंट्स अबाउट इट हाउ टू हैव योर कूल जिसे कहते हैं क्योंकि ये मैं सिर्फ मैं अभी बोल रही हूँ तो उससे आई डोंट थिंक देखने वाले सिर्फ एक मिनट में सीख जाएंगे आई थिंक यू नीड टू वर्क ऑन दिस वेयर यू कीपिंग योर कूल
व्हाट आर सम चैनल्स दैट यू थिंक दैट और सम वेज दैट पीपल कैन वर्क ऑन देमसेल्व्स Not just, I mean, people look for different outlets. Koi music, you know, they go towards the music. Hmm. They play instruments. Koi art ki taraf jata hai for some sort of satisfaction. Hmm. They paint. They use their hands. They get, you know, they go play sports and they kind of, you know, get that anger out of them or frustration out of them. So, what are some other aspects or venues that you think might be good for Pakistani, you know?
I think you named two very important ones: arts. मेरे क्लाइंट्स को बहुत हेल्प हुई है कई दफ़ा वे दे वॉन्टेड टू गो सबसे पहले तो नाइला इससे पहले एक स्टेप आता है ना जब आपको जानना है कि मैं हूँ कौन और मुझे किस चीज़ से रिलैक्सेशन मिलती है तो वहीं पे आधे क्लाइंट्स और आधे स्टूडेंट्स रुक जाते हैं बिकॉज द थिंग्स दैट दे वॉन्ट टू डू आर सो स्टिग्मेटाइज्ड सो द फर्स्ट स्टेप इज़ द अवेयरनेस ऑफ वट आई वॉन्ट एज अ यंग पर्सन एज अ यंग एडल्ट एंड वट आई रियली वॉन्टेड टू डू विद इट म्यूजिक और स्पोर्ट्स और पेंटिंग और मे बी हेल्पिंग पीपल देयर वाज अ स्टूडेंट ऑफ माइन हु वॉन्टेड टू जस्ट sit in the ye jo jhopriyan wagera bani hoti hain he just wanted to go there and spend some time there and his mother would think that he's crazy and then later on he went on to you know make a small ngo there and he used to
oh,
spend
that's
most
wonderful.
of his time there and i and but he was so stigmatized he was so pressurized to leave that
to be the perfect kind of student son
but ultimately he left his studies which is unfortunate because of the school system hamara aisa hai ki you have to be but he was so invested in that and he's still there and is very happy he actually lives there
oh
yeah,
okay
he has a house there thoda sa banaya hua hai apne
gaon ke but very minimalistic
yes
okay yeah. okay that's so, wonderful
ek ye bhi to example hai but he's a nightmare for his parents
yeah that's true so, I mean but then again so was Steve Jobs
yes
you know
exactly.
we have to look exactly. at all of these wonderful role models that have risen to fame and obtained such a stature within the society global society as well aap Mark Zuckerberg ko dekh le
bilkul
you know he dropped out from I think Harvard
and aur bade pareshan rahe honge unki family wale
ki we spend so much money and you know the way jo guilt parents karte hain ki we did so much for you why are you doing this to us and the whole manipulation so how do we kind of you know stick in our own how do we make it our how do we do what we want to do you know what are the ways
by knowing what you that you what you are doing is right
and how do we know what we're doing is right
just think I am an able person I have self worth
but a lot of the times our like the student body or the youth population kind of feels that they have no idea and they go to their parents that oh for example we want to pursue music and you know the parent goes that you can't have a career in music you are not it's not a stable career it's not financially lucrative and you know bahut kam cases hote hain jaise Ali Zafar ho gaya other system ho gaya ya
bahut rare
cases hote hain ki you become a sensational you know or you become an icon global icon so how can we make our parents understand this that this is our life and this is something that we want to do And you've lived your life with all due respect. But how do we kind of go forward?
They're very authentic sentiments, Naila, coming especially from someone who has graduated recently. Yeah, and they're very authentic, they're very valid. But unfortunately, again, it's a generational problem. So I don't think there's a one way of making your parents understand. I think it varies. But I think the first step that I took also, but again I had help from therapy, but the first step was मुझे पता था जब मैं अपनी मम्मी को अप्रोच करती थी कि मैं ठीक हूँ. हमारे आधा टाइम हमारा आर्गुमेंट क्यों फेल हो जाता है किसी के साथ भी, बी एट योर पेरेंट और योर को वर्कर और योर बॉस, बिकॉज यू हैव दिस 50-50, एम आई राइट,
एम आई रॉन्ग, इस आई कर
रही हूँ, बिकॉज ऑफ कोर्स द जजमेंट्स ऑफ सोसाइटी, वेयर यू हैव बीन ब्रॉट अप इन अ सोसाइटी वेयर देयर आर लॉट ऑफ जजमेंट ऑफ राइट एंड रॉन्ग, एवरीथिंग हैज टू बी आइदर राइट और आइदर इट्स वेरी रॉन्ग. So you go to an argument, you enter a conversation with your parents with a mindset where you're not sure, which is exactly given by them, but now you have internalized it, and now you are not sure as a student or as a graduate, or myself, that I'm right. So when I'm not sure, Naila, then I can't convince you.
Yeah.
So you have to be sure of yourself. If young people are watching this, whatever you are thinking, let me tell you, you are a wise person, I'm sure.
You've made it this far in life.
And if you have made it this far in the show, that means you want to know more. Yeah? You have this urge, you have the desire to know more and to listen to things. So that means you have 80 to 90% ability to make decisions which will work in some way or the other. So I have this trust in you, whoever is watching, that you will not wreck your life. Even if your parents don't have this, but I as a therapist know.
So you should have faith in yourself, and you should have, you know, 110 or 20% faith in yourself. Beshak aap sahi ho ya galat ho, but you know, when it comes to morally right,
I think आप कर ही लेंगे ठीक. हाँ, एक बात है जो मैं यूथ को कहूँगी कि फिर जिम्मेदारी अम्मी अबू पर ही डालनी, क्योंकि देखें ना, अगर आप वेस्ट में भी देखें या जहाँ भी जो इंडिपेंडेंट सोसाइटीज़ हैं जिनकी हमारी यूथ एग्जांपल देती है, फिर वो जिम्मेदारी भी उठाते हैं. आप गलती करेंगे फिर आप उसकी जिम्मेदारी उठाएंगे. यस, बट देन यू विल लर्न फ्रॉम दोज मिस्टेक्स, सब ठीक हो जाएगा इन द एंड. माई मैसेज इज थिंग्स यूजली हैव अ वे ऑफ सेटलिंग डाउन.
व्हाट आर द मेजर प्रॉब्लम्स यू सी इन पाकिस्तानी यूथ दैट kind of have rose to prominence and have kind of created a lot of issues within the society, whether bad behavior that have caused bad behavior or resentment towards certain activities, parents, you know, just in general?
I think jo teenager ke parents hain, jitna main just mili jin logon se aur jo teenagers mere paas aate hain, I think the parents again are very impatient or they're not trained to deal with a teenager. बिकॉज हमारे यहाँ अवेयरनेस इतनी ट्रेनिंग नहीं है, पेरेंटिंग का कोई डिग्री तो करते नहीं. तो आई थिंक अभी जितना कॉम्प्लिकेटेड जमाना आ गया है, देयर सो मच ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन फॉर अ टीनेजर
फ्रॉम सोशल मीडिया एज़ वेल.
यस, सो आई थिंक देयर शुड बी सम पेरेंटिंग ट्रेनिंग एंड इस पर काम हो रहा है. देयर आर मेनी पेरेंटिंग वर्कशॉप. सो आई थिंक द मेजर प्रॉब्लम इज वेयर द पेरेंट्स डू नॉट अंडरस्टैंड दैट सम टाइम इट्स मोर ऑफ फिजिकल then it's social or then it's psychological. The teenager's body is, you know, the hormones are raging.
Changing, constantly changing.
And there's hormones and there's self-image, there's a lot of peer pressure, there's a lot of, now especially with the media, they the desire to look good, the desire to look mature.
When I was young, I remember I got this blue eyeshadow ka little palette and I had no idea how to use it until I think I was 19 or 20, I had no idea. And now the youth or the young girls today are like contouring their faces and cut creases. It's just amazing.
And at 13, experience, I've had clients who were 13 or 14 and they wanted the freedom and they wanted. So I think my teenager bhi thoda confused hai because ek to wo single jo ek unit hai usme rehte hain. Pehle life thodi si asaan thi, complications bhi thi. मैं उसको प्रमोट नहीं कर रही जॉइंट फैमिली सिस्टम को, बट थोड़ा लाइफ आसान थी. वेयर द दादी एंड वाज द हेड एंड थिंग्स आइदर वर अलाउड और नॉट अलाउड, देयर वर नो ग्रे एरिया,
देयर वाज अ फाइन लाइन.
सो इट वाज इजियर इन सम वेज टू नो कि मैंने क्या करना है क्या नहीं. अब देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ लिबर्टी गिवन बाय पेरेंट्स, देयर इज अ न्यू जनरेशन ऑफ पेरेंट्स व्हिच इज ग्रेट आल्सो, जो आगे जाके उनके फायदे नजर आएंगे, बट वो लिबर्टी देते देते खुद ही परेशान हो जाते हैं एंड देन दे हैव दिस फाइट विद द टीनेजर. तो आई थिंक टीनेजर्स का सबसे बड़ा मसला ये है कि उनके पास इन्फॉर्मेशन बहुत ज़्यादा है, चॉइसेस बहुत ज़्यादा हैं, राइट एंड रॉन्ग का सख्तियाँ नहीं है.
And they don't understand which area they want to go into and how they want to be because social media is influencing them that if you become an influencer or YouTuber, you know, you can go far in
Instagram.
Life.
So I think ये थोड़ा आसानी तो हुई है हमें और मैं अलग रहने का जो पेरेंट्स का सिस्टम है, लेकिन हमें थोड़े से टीनेजर्स को प्रॉब्लम्स भी इसी से हैं मेरा ख्याल है काफ़ी हद तक, जो माँ की जिम्मेदारी बहुत ज़्यादा बढ़ गई है माँ बाप की. पहले आई थिंक माँ बाप की काफ़ी जिम्मेदारी वॉज टेकन ओवर बाय द चाचा एंड ताया एंड दादा एंड you know there were so many people
there was a whole village wo kehte hai na ki it takes village, a whole village so, to raise
the sense has its advantages of course bahut high thing lekin uske phir ye thode thode side effects hain ki phir ek teenagers are confused iske ilawa teenagers are not understood the teenagers not understood as a physical
I remember when I was a child well when I was growing up as a teenager I felt really you know the black sheep of my family because I was the youngest and everyone else had already gone through that phase or you know had matured much faster due to their surroundings or their experiences and I wanted to go out with my friends and experience you know the typical teenage life you know have bruises and you know scrape my arm and the typical
but they had the instructions for you kaise karna hai
kaise karna hai aise nahi karna and then you know I never really got to experience that to the full and I feel like the kids now are even closed off than I was because technology has taken over
and I think teenagers ko padhai ka bhi bahut pressure hai aap mere zamane mein mujhe yaad hai there was jo a levels o levels ke grades hai ye itna nahi tha but there was very fixed views ke aapne ye doctor ban jana hai chali aap kuch kar leni hai wo ab jo ye grades ka aur academies ka aur jo main inka pressure dekhti hu
सुबह से लेकर रात तक लगे हुए होते हैं
सुबह से लेकर रात तक और आई डोंट नो पेरेंट्स को भी कोई लग गया है कंपटीशन का ए स्टार्स का और आई थिंक काफ़ी मेरे जानने वाली खवातीन को ये नहीं पता कि यूनिवर्सिटी एडमिशन्स के लिए ग्रेड्स आर सम परसेंटेज
या
बाकी तो आपकी और चीज़ें देखते हैं आई थिंक वो बहुत बड़ा प्रेशर है टीनेजर्स
अच्छा तो आई थिंक थोड़ी सी प्रोफेशनल बातें बहुत ज़्यादा हो गई हैं आई वॉन्ट टू नो अबाउट यू सो यू स्टडीड इन द यूनाइटेड किंगडम and you've you know had your experience and you've studied in Pakistan as well and yahan ka bhi experience tha so how do you compare both of the experiences with each other
I think I looked at the experience mostly through the lens through the eyes of a woman who grew up in Pakistan who was not free to do a lot of things and then when I went there was a lot of
liberty
to be freedom to be आप कुछ लोग फ्रीडम को थोड़ा नेगेटिवली भी देखते हैं जब मैं लफ्ज़ बोलती हूँ कि पता नहीं क्या आज़ादी मिल गई होगी हाँ बट ये जो मुझे फ्रीडम था टू जस्ट थिंक द फ्रीडम टू गो आउट एट नाइट और इन द मॉर्निंग फॉर ग्रोसरी डबल रोटी के लिए यहाँ तो डबल रोटी के लिए वेट करना पड़ता है किसी का वॉक करके नहीं निकल सकते सुबह हो जाए गाड़ी हो प्रॉपर आप प्रॉपरली ड्रेस्ड हो देन यू कैन गो वहाँ पे वो कुछ भी पहना है कुछ भी किया है तो जब रोटी देने खुद निकल पड़े वो मुझे बहुत पसंद आता था वहाँ पे आई वाज रियली इनामर्ड बाय द होल आइडिया ऑफ दिस कि आई कैन बी एंड आई वोंट बी लुक्ड एट
और ऑल गर्ल्स
तो वो मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगता था पढ़ाई में थोड़ा ही था कि हमें बहुत फिक्स माइंड सेट था हमारा पढ़ाई में हमें रट्टा मार लेना है याद
कर
लेना है जी वहाँ जाके जो एक चीज़ थी ना एक तो पढ़ाई करनी है दूसरा रिफ्लेक्शन ऑन माई पढ़ाई करनी है
ओके
रिफ्लेक्टिव राइटिंग वाज समथिंग वेरी न्यू फॉर मी बट आई हैव टू राइट रिफ्लेक्टिवली ऑन व्हाट आई लर्न व्हाट आई नीड टू लर्न राइट जो वहाँ पे स्टूडेंट्स जिम्मेदारी डाली जाती थी हमारे लेवल पे एटलीस्ट मास्टर्स पे एम एस पे फिर आई need to set goals for my own learning what do I need to learn
what's next for you
what's
you
next
know?
for me yeah. so this was very difficult for me kyunki mujhe zara feeding ki shuru se padhai ki to bataya gaya ki ye padhna hai ye exam mein aayega to being responsible for my own studies setting goals for my own self for studies ki mujhe kya learn karna hai and then reflecting back on what did I study
okay so you lived in the united kingdom but I'm sure you traveled as well you know different parts of europe as well so how was that experience
it was good mujhe ek experience bahut yaad hai switzerland ka jahan main ek farm ke samne se guzar rahi thi aur sabziyan wahan openly kheton ke bahar padi to maine unse guide se pucha ki ye kya hai usne kaha ki jo farmer hai wo to bahut busy hai wo yahan dukaan to nahi laga sakta to wo subah subah apni sari sabziyan काट के फल वगैरह उतार के यहाँ रख देता है टोकरियों में साथ ही वेइंग स्केल पड़ा हुआ है और रेट्स लिखे हुए हैं
अच्छा।
और साथ पैसों का डब्बा है
ओ।
तो हम लोग आते हैं और हम लोग खुद लेते हैं अपनी पसंद का हम खुद उनको वे करते हैं उतने पैसे उसके डब्बे में डाल देते हैं और सामान ले जाते हैं तो दिस वॉज समथिंग जो आई कुडंट बिलीव इट एंड आई आस्क्ड हिम अगेन कि ये क्या कह रहे हो हाँ देखो पूरी लाइन में फार्म्स थे मुझे याद है ज्यूरिक में थी तो ये चीज़ मेरे लिए बड़ी मार थी कि वो इतनी ऑनेस्टी थी इतनी वो कि वो खुद ही ट्रस्ट था जो उनका जो एक कम्युनिटी सिस्टम है ना वो मुझे बहुत पसंद है और आई थिंक वही कम्युनिटी सिस्टम मैंने पाकिस्तान में हुंजा में देखा है वेयर द कम्युनिटी एट द स्मॉल लेवल रादर देन ब्लेमिंग द इंस्टीट्यूशन रादर देन ब्लेमिंग द गवर्नमेंट और वेटिंग फॉर द गवर्नमेंट टू कम इन दे हेल्प द कम्युनिटी दिमसेल्व सो वो जो एक आपस में वो है ना, वो मैं बड़ा मिस करती हूँ पाकिस्तान में वापस आई हूँ तो, या हमें दिल करता है कि हमारे पास भी हो. हालांकि कम्युनिटी सिस्टम तो आई थिंक नाइला हमने ही, हमारे मज़हब ने ही कॉन्सेप्ट दिया था, द मॉस्क वाज बेसिकली मेंट टू बी अ कम्युनिटी सर्विस सेंटर, कम्युनिटी सेंटर, बट वो हमें नहीं है तो वो मुझे वहाँ बाहर जाके बहुत लगा जो
Oh my god, that's wonderful. But I think that's all the time we have for today. I learned so much from you and I don't want the time to end.
Yes, bahut jaldi gudar gaya.
I know, but I think time ho gaya, but aapne chai bhi nahi li, aapne lasagna bhi nahi order liya. I'm kind of sad. But thank you so much. I've learned so much from you and I hope our viewers learned a lot from you as well. And
one message that you are worthy and you can make the right decision whatever age you are.
Can you just repeat that, you know, a little bit louder so everyone can just hear it?
Whoever is watching, I want to tell them that you are worthy, you have self-worth as a person who you are, and you can make right decisions for yourself. I'm not saying you will make the right decision for your parents, but you will make the right decision for yourself at the time.
Oh my goodness. When the decision
is needed, and I'm sure you will bear the consequences if something goes wrong. But then you will get up again. That is my message.
So when you fall, you have to get back up.
Oh yes, trust me. Okay. Things will settle.
Oh my god, thank you for your words of wisdom and thank you so much for your time and
thank you for having me, thank you
for joining me and Tahira Malik at Tangelos here in Islamabad, and I'll see you guys next time. Take care, lafiz. Oh, so aaj humne chicken lasagna khaya at Tangelos in Islamabad and it was probably the best lasagna that I've ever had in a very long time. It was the perfect amount of spicy and the pasta to the sauce ratio was also perfect. Aur cheese though, I think I was in cheese heaven. But main aapko recipe uski bata deti hu very quickly. Chicken lasagna mein, it's a taste of Italy. So unhone dala tha chicken, mushroom, olives, creamy tomato sauce and cheese. And feel free to add whatever veggies you want, matlab koi capsicum dal liya, if you want to add a little bit of onions or something like that, or even chilies to make it an extra, you know, boost of spice. So feel free to try this at home and let us know in the comments.